Hi, my name is Felix Müller. I'm Product Manager for Camunda Optimize. And that's why I'm also happy to share some of my thoughts regarding continuous process improvement using process metrics. So today we have seen Ben demonstrated already some of the capabilities of the Camunda BPM stack. And we're going to focus now over the next 20 minutes on the improve phase. So process improvement, that's what it's all about. When we look at Camunda Optimize as a tool, it's mainly used for end-to-end process monitoring and analytics, which helps you in your process of continuous improvement in the end. It allows you to create your own customized dashboards based on process data. And it allows you also to create all different kinds of reports that you can place on these dashboards. So that could be simple bar and line charts, as you know them maybe from other reporting tools. But what is very special about Camunda Optimize is that you can also directly embed the process diagram that you have created with the other Camunda tools directly in your report. And we then allow you to place very nice visualizations on top of these process diagrams. As you can see here on the right-hand side on a screenshot, that would be a simple heat map diagram that shows you, as an example, bottlenecks in your process. On top of these reports and dashboards, it also includes alerting capabilities, so you can inform you if certain thresholds are met, can happen via webhooks or alternatively also via email. And the lastly, from my point of view, the most important part about this whole application, Camunda Optimize, is that the setup is so easy and it takes only a few seconds to get started with it. So if you already have an existing Camunda installation with your runtime engine as an example, this creates all different kinds of data. And once you configure it Optimize to point to that process engine that you have maybe in production or in development, then it will automatically import all that data into Optimize, which allows you then to directly get started with these reports. So there's basically no custom integration necessary, no development effort, which is really nice to then get these benefits out of the tool. As you can see, this is the architecture I just mentioned. Optimize can run, we provide Docker images, or also you can just install it as a Java distribution, connected to an Elasticsearch in the cloud, or also a local cluster that you may eventually have, and then configure one or multiple REST engines of a Camunda engine. And I don't want to spend too much time today in architecture, but I rather want to jump into it. Demonstration, because I think that's the best way how we can demonstrate the capabilities of Optimize. And what I would like to do is I would like to follow up directly on the process and the automated process that Ben has just shown. So we're going to reuse the same example that we have seen before to make it very easy for you to understand what we are talking about. As you can see, I've already logged in as a demo user here in my environment. Similar to what we have seen also in Cavemo, Optimize allows you to kind of organize all of your reports and dashboards that you're creating in your system in something that we call a collection. So similar to projects, they allow you to just organize all your work that you have done. And as we can see, I prepared already some information here, some dashboard for our demonstration today. So as you can see here, we have a bank account application KPI dashboard in our scenario. Let me just quickly turn off those filters so that you can see a little bit more. And what we can see is that here in the first chart, as an example, we got already 56 applications this month in for our bank account. Our goal was 145, so we are almost there, kind of. If we scroll down, this is where, to me, the most interesting part actually happens for Optimize. It's about the process diagrams. As you can see, we are very flexible here, so we can drill in a little bit, and then we can hover over the different BPMN elements that we have. We could also click on this report and make it a little bit bigger. Scroll in and see, okay, we have 610 times we executed this decide on application, whereas we got about 1,200 applications in total, which means 50% of our applications are manually processed, which could be already an alarming factor for us, because we want to, of course, streamline our process and make it as efficient as possible. And that's obviously the case in these top or lower branches where we completely fully automate the process. Whenever we look at reports in Optimize and also on dashboards, Optimize allows us to also drill even deeper. So not only showing the process diagram, but we can also always inspect the raw data, the underlying process instance information that is being used by the process engine. So here, as an example, we can see the two different applications that Ben already created. This includes not only start and end time and duration of these process instances, but also includes information about the process context, which is very valuable, especially in scenarios where we want to filter or use that for further reporting. If we scroll down a little bit, this is another example here of process data I talked about. So we can see here, for example, the different risk evaluations, what were the results of them for our applications over the last months. So we see over time we have more green risks per month compared to red risks, which are decreasing a little bit, which is probably also positive that we are allowing for more bank openings. Also here, another pie chart for the frequency of the category for the different packages for our bank accounts. What you can also do is you can look into every report and show you what kind of filters are currently active. Why is that relevant? Because on the dashboard level, you are now with Optimize 3.1, so the latest edition, also able to filter directly on the dashboard across all the different reports that you set up, which simplifies the usage a lot compared to other versions that we had before. So we could, for example, say, okay, right now I'm only interested in what happens with our basic package bank opening applications. And then if I scroll down, all the numbers are automatically updated. We could also inspect, okay, what is the average duration for our Decide on application for the basic packages compared maybe to our, let's say, standard package, which is probably very similar. But you can imagine how that works. We can also filter directly on, let's say, the instance state. So we could also look at completed or running instances. So that is another point that is very important about Optimize. We are always looking at near real-time data. That's why I said earlier before process monitoring. Optimize makes sure that with a very small delay of a couple of seconds, we always have the latest data from the process engine from our production environment. So we are not looking at old data from last day or last week, but this is always near real-time. What we can also see if we scroll down a little bit, there are also decision tables visible, so we can see which rules hit most often or maybe which rules were never hit. That allows us as well to then over time approve decision tables, because we can eventually get rid of certain decisions or rules in our decision table, which will make them a little bit more compact and easier to understand. Besides these dashboarding capabilities, which also allow me, of course, to share that with other people, so I can create a view-only link of my dashboard that I can open in a different tab, maybe, if I'm interested in that, to get a view-only version of that. We are also able with Optimize to create alerts on top of different important KPIs that we created. So I, for example, created here a KPI that shows me or that sends me automatically an email whenever we reach 100 applications per month. We could do the same thing on durations. Often durations are even more relevant for process improvement, just as an example. And as a last step before we go back to the slides, and I want to show you some of our real world examples of the usage of Optimize, I'm just going to walk you quickly through how you can actually create such reports so that you have a feeling of how simple it is. So we're going to just create a new entity. We're going to choose our customer onboarding process. We say, okay, we are interested in all versions of that process. We directly see the process diagram, and then we say, hey, maybe I'm interested in the heat map as a flow node count. And then I directly get the diagram here, which shows me the heat map. I can customize that. So I can say, maybe we are interested in the durations, and maybe we are not interested in the average durations, but always in the maximum durations of the different steps. And this is maybe process step durations. We can also add additional filters to say we only want to look at completed instances, or we only want to look at a specific category, which would be maybe our base package, and then we save that. All the process variables are available out of the box that you created in your process, as long as they're simple variable types. If they're complex, you can also add them on your own relatively easily and customize them to the way you need it. So this way, we just created together in a couple of seconds a new dashboard. Okay, so that's just a very quick walkthrough through Optimize. And now we're just gonna jump back into the slide deck, because I want to, as I said, show you also some real-life examples. Sorry about that. So real-life process metrics. It's a little bit hot here, so I'm just gonna drink a bit. It's almost like fireballs here in Berlin. It's really, really hot. So one of the examples I wanted to show you is one of our customers, Visana, so it's a Swiss insurance. So that I wanted to bring to you because they are a heavy user of Camunda as well. And what's special about them, they were running Camunda for a couple of years already in production. And then they decided at some point, okay, we want to get insights into our processes even more, and decided to implement process analytics with the help of Optimize. And what I find particularly interesting is that they are giving themselves a specific promise to their customers. So whenever a new insurance policy is asked for on their website, they want to process that within 20 minutes. They have very specific internal SLAs on that. And then also as another KPI, they want to deliver benefits within 8 days to their end customers, to the insured people. And Optimize allows them now for the first time to really track those numbers for their Camunda process. So it helps them really to get actionable insights into where are actually bottlenecks in my process. They're using something similar to what we are seeing here in this dashboard. So there, Optimize allows you to look, for example, into the application duration that is relatively long in our scenario, but could be also only these 20 minutes that we have seen earlier. So I think that's quite interesting in their scenario, how well that works. Another interesting example I brought here is from Helsana, also by chance, another insurance customer from Switzerland. Little bit similar somehow, but what is there really special about that is that they are using the dashboards for the whole company, kind of to visualize what kind of process, what the core processes are all about, and how many open process instances they have at the moment, to make everyone in the company aware of the fact that they're working on the same goal of making sure that the customers in the end are really happy and they're able to process all of their applications and everything very quickly and in a very nice manner. And that makes everyone aware of that in the whole organization and in their use case. And also it leads to many discussions in front of the TV, and then people give maybe improvement recommendations because they see, hey, maybe there's a problem from time to time in that area. BPMN is very powerful in communicating processes and also helps everyone to easily understand what's going on. That's a big power of Optimize as well. I wanted to talk a little bit more also about theoretically what is important for continuous process improvement. From my perspective, it's about two things. It's about high-level process metrics in two different scenarios, or in two different key metrics, which is about duration and the other one is about counts, right? And there we can look at end-to-end process durations or single steps or even more granular, very fine-grained durations of user tasks as an example. Or when we look at counts, that we look at started and ended instances or instances that took a very specific path in our process. And then we want to compare those numbers. On top of that, always when we talk about continuous improvement, we hear from our customers that it's very important that we have near real-time data at large scale. So no matter if we have 1,000 process instances or millions, 10 million or more, like as an example, 24-hour fitness, they have large amounts of process instances with Camunda, and they want to use Optimize still at that large scale. They want to get accurate and easy access to such tool, and also self-service. As we have just seen, I can create reports in seconds, and I don't have to ask another data warehouse team to create those reports for me. And I'm very flexible with visualizations. So from my point of view, it's about these high-level metrics. And on top of that, besides these requirements that are kind of meta requirements for me, it's important about this deep analysis, right? I want to be able to distinguish between different context process variables that I have in my process. The time is always an important factor, running completed processes. But on top of that, that very simple BPMN specific analysis. So as an example, I brought today human workflow KPIs. There we have very specific needs in these scenarios, because user tasks often consist of the full duration, but also the time that is just idling, right? No one has picked up work yet, but it's just lying around, and we are waiting for someone from our staff to work on the item, and then the actual work time. We want to compare all of that and look at in detail how do these numbers compare, so that we know how we can improve. And we want to look at, okay, how are these teams doing compared to each other maybe. So yeah, just a couple of examples and dashboards that I created as an example to show you what is possible in Optimize. And I had to create all of this manually, but it's not necessary. So you could also automatically use Optimize to show you, okay, there are certain important factors in your process diagram where you need to take action. Optimize is capable of that as well. Using the outlier analysis, it shows me that in this task, there are a couple of instances that take longer than average. I get a distribution chart, and then I can also identify, okay, certain context of process variables leads to bad performance, and then I can take care of that and solve my process. And I'm looking at Stefan because I'm almost over time. I just want to take two more minutes and then I will hand over to you. He's giving approved, so that's good. Now we kind of looked at dashboards, and we looked at high-level KPIs, deep KPIs, and Optimize. All of that is nice. But let's imagine you have this customer onboarding process, but you haven't orchestrated it yet completely with Camunda. Eventually, parts of your process are maybe still in a legacy system, or maybe you have an output management system and you're still interested in this process analysis. Well, now you think that's not possible, but well, it is with Optimize 3.0 that we have released this year. Since this version, we allow you to ingest events from different systems into Optimize, no matter if they're from Camunda or from external systems, legacy applications, microservices, or RPA bots as well, very important these days, so that you can then create your own process diagram or reuse that from Cavemo, import it, map your process, and then get the same reports as we have seen them today, already earlier with the event monitoring feature. That was a very, very quick overview about Camunda Optimize. Feel free to later in the fireside chat also to ask more questions, or in Slido as well. Happy to answer them. So I will stay on here for a while. And I hope I got you a little bit interested in the usage of Optimize today. I'm very much looking forward also to your feedback. And with that, I'm handing over to Stefan.